The subject of the song Radioactive by Imagine Dragons is about ex-convicts being released from prison and their experience readjusting. This song illustrates the occasion that many ex-convicts go through. Interestingly, it is also rumored that the inspiration for this song is a friend of many of the band's members who is also a former prisoner. The target audience is the general public, as the purpose of the song is to help raise awareness about the predicament and hardships of ex-felons. The speaker is an anonymous person who serves as a microcosm for the many victims of post-prison life. The tone is very somber and solemn, as this is a very serious topic being addressed.
In this line, the waking up to the ash and dust is an ironic phrase because normally waking up represents clarity, but instead ash and dust represent obscurity and darkness. When prisoners leave, as they are supposed to be free, however, the ash and the dust represent the loss of opportunity and failure, as well as the stigma surrounding ex-convicts. This also represents the prisoner's first view when coming out of the prison. They are looking at the remains of their world before prison, but because they've been in prison so long, they don't recognize the world when they get out. I wipe my brow and I
sweat my rust. In this line, the sweating of the rust is a metaphor for the whole prisoner mentality, which is the psychological wall that people develop in prison. If you've ever seen The Shawshank Redemption, this situation is analogous to Brooks, who also finds it difficult to readjust to society. The sweating is the prisoners trying their best to readjust to society by getting rid of their prisoner mentality, which is often a huge obstacle ex-felons must overcome. I'm breathing in the
chemicals. This line is also ironic because one's leave of prison is supposed to represent a breath of fresh air. However, the former prisoner is actually breathing in chemicals, which represents the toxicity of the new age, as will be mentioned later in the song. After the line chemicals, you hear the prisoner gasp, which is them struggling for air, or rather struggling in the new age after prison.
Here, the prisoners are looking through the bars as if they're afraid of what is on the outside, similar to how prisoners are nervous about going back into society, as they know how hard life will be. This scene is also ironic because it seems that the prisoners would almost just be safer behind bars. We also see a dirty and grimy guitar, which harkens back to the lyric of Ash and Dust.
Here we have assonance in the words breaking, shaping, and checking. It is also important to note the repetition of the tense. The ing is important because it helps the listener recognize that this is happening in the present and is a very current issue. The man is shown to be powerful and to have a key around his neck. It is also important to note the imagery of the key. This is a metaphor for the warden of the prison and by extension the government in general, which is partly responsible for the trouble ex-convicts have in attempting to readjust to society.
This is it, the apocalypse, is more evidence to support the idea that this is truly a horrific experience for ex-convicts, making it analogous to the apocalypse. The image of the tally marks is symbolic to the number of times champions, life, beats down challengers, the ex-convicts. Notice how there are no tally marks under the challengers, showing how released prisoners almost always fail to readjust into society and are frequently imprisoned again. The use of tally marks is appropriate because scratch marks are often left on prison walls to represent how many days a prisoner has been in the cell.
This image shows a bunch of people gathered around a fighting arena with money in their hands betting against the prisoner. You can tell the prisoner is the gray tall puppet because it has a striped and orange shirt similar to the jumpsuits of prisoners. It can be inferred that these people are the large corporations in real life who don't believe that ex-convicts can be successful, which is part of the reason why they don't hire them. This contributes to the difficulties of life that former prisoners have to endure.
It can then be inferred that the purple monster is the physical representation of life in the prisoner's eyes, It appears aggressive and difficult to beat, as it is difficult for an ex-felon to adjust back into society. Its red eyes connect back to the toxic chemical atmosphere mentioned before of the New Age.
The line, "enough to make my system blow," alludes to the ever-increasing suicide rate among ex-convicts. And why are more and more ex-convicts committing suicide? Because they're having such a hard time readjusting to society.
This image is of life continuing to beat up the ex-convicts. The line, "Welcome to the New Age," is repeated twice to illustrate how important this new period is for the former prisoners. "Welcome" is an example of verbal irony. It is almost as if they are speaking directly to these ex-convicts, welcoming them in a sarcastic tone to the New Age where they are sure to fail.
The lines and repetition of the word "radioactive" refer to the instability of radioactive elements. These elements are actually the prisoners who are so unstable after prison that they either commit suicide or commit another crime and get reincarcerated. This strengthens the purpose of the song, getting the listener to sympathize with the former prisoners.
The motion of the person running his finger across his throat, whom we previously identified as the government, is representative of the government's almost actively influencing ex-convicts to commit suicide because they fail to offer adequate support, i.e., grants that offer only what is necessary, the absolute bare minimum for substance. The image of the severed head represents just one more death of a former prisoner, who has now officially been beaten by life.
Overall, the fighting ring and those surrounding it, as shown in the video, is an allegory to the much bigger pressing issue of how ex-felons fail to work their way back into a normal life. This is due to a lack of support from the government and businesses. Having nowhere to turn, these victims either go back to a life of crime or end up committing suicide. Imagine Dragons does a wonderful job of conveying their message by having the speaker as a victim of this issue.